So everything to me. She and I and Angie were sitting around and we were talking and sharing. And one of the things I came to know over the years is that Darlene kind of had two alter egos going on there. And you had some people that knew her as Darla, and then there was some, you know, you might have had to be a little bit closer to her, but you also knew Nathan. And so Darla was a lot like, you know, she was Darlene, you know, and she was that first lady, you know, that person to pray with you, and that person to sing like an angel, that church girl, that's who she was. And what I learned is that Danky went to church too, but I think her church was kind of on the edge of the hood. And so, based on which one of you saw on which day, and what was going on determined who you met. And I was sitting and I was talking with her and talking with Angie, and I was telling them about a very trying time that I had just gone through and the things that I was going through. And she and Angie, they were being friends like always, and they were encouraging me and, you know, saying they were going to pray with me, telling me about experiences and things and knowledge that they had. And when it was all over, we kind of parted ways. Then nearing the end of that evening, as we were about to leave, Darlene walked back up to me again, and she looked at me and she said, "Kendra," she said, "don't let nobody mess with you." She told me, she said, "if anybody mess with you, you better call me," and I mean it. She said, don't make my being sick an excuse for you not calling me. She said, "if I'm in the hospital, you better call me." She said, "I will check myself out, and I might have a needle coming out of this hand, but it's gonna be a switchblade coming out of the other." And she said, "we gonna take care of business, and I'm gonna go back and check myself in, and everything gonna be all right." And as I left that place, I thought about it later on. I said, "Lord, somehow, Danky got past security." But I thank God, because everybody needs a Darlene, and everybody needs a Danky. And I praise God for that. When Bernard reached out to me and asked me about writing a poem, I did not know that it would necessarily be a poem. I just wanted there to be a tribute. And I struggled with this. It took me a while to get it written, and it normally does not. But at the end of the day, I have something written for her that is a dedication to her. And it's simply called "Always an Angel." They say there are angels among us that live with us every day. They walk like us, talk like us, need like us, even bleed like us. But they're angels, that's what they say. God places these extraordinary people on earth as living directions. They stay with us, pray with us, they love us in spite of us. They are God's appointed reflections. To be assigned to one of these angels is truly a blessing beyond measure. To be carried by one, even married to one, to be friends with one until the end with one. We have memories we all will treasure. God's word implies that it's true, that angels can be here or there. We meet them, eat with them, laugh with them, sing with them. We entertain them unaware. I'm convinced we had a chosen one and a woman we knew as Darlene. She didn't just become an angel last Wednesday. That's just when she got her wings.